Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 12th video class of DIP, we will study one other piecewise linear transformation function, that is bit plane slicing, and of course its implementation in MATLAB. So starting with the name itself, bit plane slicing means we'll be slicing different bit planes from an image. An image is made up of 8 bit planes, and if we slice each bit plane separately, we can have different applications from bit plane slicing. So let us start. So we know that piecewise linear transformation function is a function which is linear in different pieces or different parts. It is a spatial domain method, that is, we are performing operations on the image plane itself, and it is used for manipulation of an image so that the result is more suitable than the original for specific applications. We have already studied contrast stretching and intensity or gray level slicing in the previous video classes. In this video class, we will be studying bit plane slicing. So we know that a digital image is made up of pixels, and these pixels are digital numbers which are composed of bits. A 256 grayscale image is composed of 8 bits. The gray level of each pixel in a digital image is stored as one or more bytes in a computer. For an 8-bit image, 0 is encoded as 8 zeros, whereas 255 is encoded as 8 ones. The bit in the far left side is referred to as the MSB or the most significant bit, because a change in that bit would significantly change the value encoded by the byte. Conversely, the bit in the far right is referred to as the LSB or least significant bit, because a change in this bit does not change the encoded gray level value much. So instead of highlighting intensity level ranges, we could highlight the contribution made to the total image appearance by specific bits. 8-bit image may be considered as composed of 8 1-bit planes, with plane 1 containing the lowest order bit of all the pixels in the image, and plane 8 all the highest order bits. The bit plane representation of an 8-bit digital image is shown over here. So bit plane 1 is composed of the least significant bits or LSBs, and bit plane 8 is composed of the most significant bits or MSBs. One 8-bit byte or one pixel is composed of 1 bits from each of these planes. Bit plane slicing is a method of representing an image with one or more bits of the byte used for each pixel. One can only use MSB to represent the pixel, which reduces the original gray level to binary image, and similarly we can represent the images with different bit planes. The four main applications of bit plane slicing are converting a gray level image to a binary image, next representing an image with fewer bits and corresponding the image to a smaller size, that is image compression. Number three, we are enhancing the image by focusing specific bit planes. And number four, we can also use bit plane slicing for stagenography, that is hiding the information in one of the bit planes and transmitting it. This image shows a 8-bit grayscale image. This is bit plane 1 out of the 8 bit planes of this image. Bit plane 2, bit plane 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So you can see from this figure that most of the information is present in the higher bit planes, or you can say bit planes from 5 to 8. When we implement such bit plane slicing in MATLAB for our image, if this is our original image, that is maulik.png, bit plane 1 will be like this, bit plane 2, bit plane 3, bit plane 4, and from bit plane 5 onwards, you can see major of the important information of the image. While performing the same bit plane slicing to the coins image of MATLAB, you can again see that major of the information is in between bit plane 5 to bit plane 8. Of course, bit plane 3 and 4 also has some of the information. So let us implement this bit plane slicing in MATLAB. Initially, I am reading my image maulik.png and converting the image into RGB to gray. Next, I am storing the value of 1 pixel from the image at the location 10 to 60 into R, so that we can see the value of that particular pixel, and converting the decimal value into binary value by using decimal to binary of R. I am subplotting the image into 3x3 matrix, and in the very first location, I am showing my original grayscale image. Next, using the MATLAB command bitget, I am extracting the lowest order of all pixels from the image and storing into the first bit plane. Bitget is a MATLAB function used to fetch a bit from the specified position from all the pixels. So from all the pixels, it will be taking the lowest order bit and storing into B. Next, I am subplotting this B and giving the title bit plane 1. I'll be using logical while showing the image because we are performing operations on bit. Whenever we are performing bitwise operation, we have to use logical command. Similarly, I'll be getting the second values of all the bits and storing into bit plane 2, further in bit plane 3, bit plane 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And I'll be showing all the bit planes in the figure. Let us run this particular portion and see the output. So you can see this figure shows our original image, bit plane 1, that is the LSB that is extracted from all the pixels of the image, then bit plane 2, bit plane 3, bit plane 4, bit plane 5, 6, 7 and 8, and in bit plane 8 all the MSBs from all the pixels are extracted and stored in bit plane 8. We are reading the value of pixel at location 1060 and storing in the variable R. So let us see what is the value of this 10, 60, that is 10th row and 60th column. So this is my image. So we have to see the value of 10th row. So this is our 10th row and 60th column. And this is our 60th column. So 10th row, 60th column has the gray level value 247. So you can see that same 247 value in the command window. As we have not ended the statement with a semicolon, you will find the value of R in the command window. So command window shows that R is having value 247, and when you convert this to binary, the value is 1111011. So from this, whenever we are extracting the first bit, LSB will be extracted from each and every pixel and will be forming bit plane 1, and conversely MSB will be extracted from each and every pixel and will be stored in the bit plane 8. So you can see here we have not ended the statement with semicolon, and hence you can find the values of R and R binary in the command window. So similarly, you can find the binary values of different pixels from an image. Let us change the image to the coins image, which is the inbuilt image of MATLAB, and let us run the program again, or rather the section again, and see different bit planes of coins. So you can see this is our original coins image, and these are different bit planes that are extracted from the original image, and again most of the information is from bit plane 5 to bit plane 8. Let us see what is the value of R for the coins image at location 10 and 60. So here it is showing 51. Let us see the value at 10 and 60. So 10th row and 60th column is having the value 51, which you can find here, and of course also in the command window that R is having value 51, and the binary of 51 is 11001011. So this is how you extract different bit planes of an image. Now let us reconstruct the image using only few bit planes. So let us go to the next section of the program. Here we are combining few bit planes and reconstructing the image. So my new image, I am giving the name D, and initially I am storing zeros same as the size of my original image into D. Next, I am using bitset command of MATLAB to set the bits in D. So this bitset stores D with position bit 8 over here set to the value of bitget that is used over here. So we are getting the bit from MSB and storing in I, and that same we are setting using bitset command to 8th bit plane of image D. Similarly, we are setting the bits for 7th bit plane, 6th bit plane and 5th bit plane from the original image by extracting from the original image the 7th, 6th and 5th bit planes. And then I'll be displaying my original grayscale image and the new image side by side using the montage command. And let us see what happens when we run this particular portion. So you can see the 8 bit coins image is like this, and the 4 bit coins image that is reconstructed from bit plane 8, 7, 6 and 5 is like this and almost contains equal information, and hence you can say that you can only use 4 bit planes to represent the image and hence compress the image by 50%. That is, you are eliminating the 4 bit planes from the image, and hence the size of the image will get reduced to half. Let us run the section with our original image, and you can see that both the images are almost identical. Also, from this image, you can see that if you store some particular information or if you hide some particular information or text in bit plane 1 and combine all the bit planes and send it or transmit it, and at the receiver you will be obtaining the image like this, the original image. But when you extract the bit planes, you can extract the secret information that is stored in bit plane 1. So this is known as stagenography, which is also one of the very important applications of digital image processing, that is hiding the information and transmitting and receiving it. So that is all for this video lecture. I hope you have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. Thank you very much.